Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to have a look upon the poem Unfolding Bud, which has been written by Naoshi Koriyama. In this poem, the poet has compared two things, and those are unfolding of a water lily and unfolding of a bud. In the two comparisons, the poet tries to tell that how these two things are similar in a way of their own. In the first paragraph of the poem, which as you see I have written over here, the poet explains the unfolding of a water lily. Okay? So the lines go as, one is amazed by a water lily unfolding with each passing day. In junior classes, you might have heard about the life cycle of different fruits. Okay, like everything grows slowly, a bit higher, a bit bigger, day by day. Similarly, a water lily, it grows. First it is a tiny bud, then it opens up, then the sepals open up, after that the petals come into place. And slowly, these things happen to take place and it becomes a beautiful flower. But from the journey of a bud to a flower, that journey, the water lily takes on a richer color and new dimensions. Dimensions means it grows in size, and richer color means the color keeps on becoming more beautiful. So that is the process of unfolding of a water lily as explained by the poet. Now, in the second paragraph, which you can see written over here, in the second paragraph, the poet tells about the unfolding of a poem. In that process, in the first paragraph, the poet says that one is amazed by a water lily as it takes on new dimensions and a richer color. But in the second paragraph, the poet says that one is not amazed. When one is not amazed? At a first glance by a poet. Yani jab koi kisi kavita ko pehli dafa padhta hai, tab wo amazed nahi hota. Wo amazed kab hota hai? When he just goes and reads the poem again and again and again. Why is someone not impressed in the first glance? Someone is not impressed in the first glance of a poem because it is as tight close as a tiny bud. A poem is as tight close as a tiny bud. So a bud becomes a flower in due course of time. And a poem is understood by reading it again and again and again. Because when we read it again and again, the poem becomes a flower. In the first glance, it is as close as a tiny bud. So that is the unfolding of a poem according to the poet. In the third and the concluding paragraph, the poet finally tells that how we can unfold a poem. One is surprised. Remember, in the second paragraph, the poet had said that one is not amazed. And in the third paragraph, the poet is saying that one is surprised. When is one surprised? To see the poem. Okay? And what does the poem do? It gradually unfolds and reveals its rich inner self. Like when you used to read poems in childhood, there used to be two meanings. One was the verbal meaning and one was the real meaning, the true meaning. Okay, the explanation of the lines, which we also call as reading between the lines. So when you read a poem, when you read a piece of literature over and over again, you get to reveal its rich inner self. You get to see into the soul of the poem, the real meaning of the poem. And then, when you understand the real meaning of the poem, you are definitely surprised. So these things tell how does a poem and a bud become similar when we keep on studying. That was the lesson, guys. Stay home, stay safe, and if you have any doubts, feel free to tell in the comment section.